front.
She keyed idiot into the driver's side door.
She broke phones, plural.
I tried calling her. She erased my phone.
She's very controlling.
I can't talk. I'll call you back in just a
few. No.
I'm literally making a deal for $15,000, and you're really up.
I don't get.
They're
in the
airport, and he's gonna find a flight.
Are you coming?
Try to figure out what's.
When you have money, that's when she spreads her legs. Yeah, walk away because you're a little girl. You need to grow up.
You don't know anything.
I feel like he's suffering. I'm not gonna let Anfisa destroy him.
He's lying to me. He's hiding things from me.
I'm not gonna screw myself over just because you want to be happy.
I'm here in Miami to talk to Muhammad because he promised me we would remain friends, and he hasn't lived up to his end of the bargain. I brought the binder with me. There's conversations that he's had with women, photos that he's had with women, and I'm going to confront him with it.
Listen, I don't want to see you here anymore, okay? You are not welcome here, you understand that? I have things to do. Take your stuff and leave. You are not welcome here, so.
Our marriage, you have not been an active partner, spouse to me since we got married. I believe in marriage and take my vow serious.
I don't want to hear
about this. I married you because I loved you. And because, here, you can take this too so you know how serious this is.
That was nice of you.
You are a user, Muhammad. You used me. You told me what I wanted to hear to get me to pull that annulment.
Nice, nice.
I am going to guarantee I will get your ass deported because you're a user.
I'm going to call police on her.
You backstabbed me this whole time.
I need police as soon as possible.
It's very hurtful that he's called the cops on me because Muhammad's supposed to be a person that said that he loved me and was here to build a life with me. But yet he's turned my life into misery.
That's her. Hello?
Where are you?
That's just an attention thing, I feel like. I'm pulling over.
Why did you leave? You told me you're gonna come back.
What do you want?
She's calling me up and texting me and trying to FaceTime me and see where I'm at and trying to control every move that I do.
Hello?
What's the problem? You told me you were going home and you're coming back.
Well,
what?
What are you doing?
This is the kind of I have to go through all the time.
What is the problem? I am coming back. I am coming back.
I brought you here. I trusted you.
Why
I don't
did you
have
do that?
To do that just because I'm obligated to. I do that because I love and care about you.
You made me give up to everything and come here to be with you.
He was trying to put the blame on me, and it hurt because he does not want to take no responsibility at all for his actions.
The only way to move on is to get a divorce. So what you're trying to do is to get me deported. That's what you're trying to do?
I feel used by you. You were supposed to make a life here with me.
So you are a selfish person. What about me? It was giving me a hard time. You made me hate myself in that time. That's why I don't want to be your husband. So you don't screw my life. You killed everything inside me.
I feel like Daniel is saying, like, look what I have against you, be with me, or otherwise I will kick you out of the country. And that's not nice. That's like trying to make me a slave.
Just move on, go find someone else better than me. And then we get my divorce.
I feel used and like trash. Why would I want you to stay here?
It's not your country. It's not your house. You don't have the keys of this country. This country is for everybody
else. No, not when there's other people responsible for you and you get in trouble by the government.
I'm gonna stay here. Mohammed. I'm gonna stay here.
No, you're not.
I'm not like you asking for the government help. Here we go.
I feel like he's using me for the green card.
I'll pay.
I do need another chance to talk to her again because I already made it here to Ohio. So I feel like I don't deserve going back with nothing.
I don't know. I'm gonna have to go home and think about all this.
I want the chance to talk to her again. At least we talk and make a decision.
Wow. You know, obviously, I don't have $20,000 in cash right now.
So it's not my problem.
So it's not your problem?
Yes.
And she's just very controlling. She likes to be bossy. And I kind of like that. I kind of like her firmness of, you know, her standing her ground, but I'll also stand my ground too. So, you know, that's where conflict comes into play.
Then why did we even started getting this visa? Why did you bring me here? You're not ready.
It's not that I'm not ready, but...
You're not ready.
It's not that I'm not ready. I'm just saying that it's like...
Can you just be straightforward and not like, oh, yes and
yeah,
no?
Yeah, I am straightforward. All right, so the straightforward part is that you want expensive things and it's, you know, hard for me to keep up.
That's all I can say? Nice. It's always nice talking to you.
It's
somebody
not...
as smart as me.